Hello everyone. How you doing? Still feeling invigorated? I know it's late in the day. Thank you very much. I know it's a bit late in the day. And a lot of what I've covered, a lot of what's been covered also forms my presentation. So I'll skip through some of it because it's been covered kind of extensively already by Maria and Abel and the kind of lifestyle aspect.
Obviously, you're not from the Dominican Republic.
Well done.
So, where are you from?
This happens in Australia, really. Did you guys get a lot of Australian films back in the States?
No, I haven't at all.
Has anyone got any other suggestions?
London, England.
Well done. Yeah, I'm from South London. But I did one of these recently in the Dominican Republic, and they all thought I was Australian as well. I've been gone a long time.
But
so
you say oi. Oi is not Australian.
Yeah, well, I was looking for oi. First time I met you.
You haven't said mate.
Yeah, I'm from South London as well, so my accent is even more different from the Australian North. Right, this is the company I work for. I work for a company called Real Capital Corimbe. We're first and foremost an investment company. So we've been established now for a number of years, and we have property in Miami, for example, under asset management, and we've done construction in other countries as well. My background is essentially a developing country, so my background is Costa Rica, Philippines, Cape Verde in Africa, and developing nations in general. And I've been on and off now in the Dominican Republic for the last 2 to 3 years. So I'm going to tell you about the two projects that we're currently constructing. One is nearly finished, and the other one is set to start probably next month. So the company's called Real Capital Ventures is the official title. And this is just an introduction to the kind of concerns facing investors nowadays throughout the world. I mean, most of my clients are professional investors, some of them are lifestyle buyers. But this is just an illustration, if you like, about some of the pitfalls when you're looking at investing overseas. So the big one, the main one, the one that applies to me, and this is kind of ironic with me being an Australian from London, we've just voted to leave the European Union, and that's had drastic ramifications to the British economy and to other economies as well, but to a lesser degree rely on the British economy, like Ireland, for example, the whole North, Southern Ireland thing, border across Northern Ireland when we're out of Europe, and also relationships with other countries. Specifically France and Germany. I don't know if you're familiar with that. Venezuela is another one. You're all familiar with, who's familiar with what's going on in Venezuela? Everyone, I guess, you've seen it on the news. Maduro's being a bully. The Philippines, I spent 7 years in the Philippines. The Philippines was a real hot investment spot in Asia for a number of years, even in spite of the ownership laws there, because you can't, as a foreign national, buy land. If you invest in a company or you want to buy land, you have to have a Filipino partner, which is chaotic, nevertheless. And they just voted in a new president, and he's been running around shooting everyone and causing chaos and upheaval. And, hopefully it recovers in the future because it's a beautiful country. But and the American election, which I'm not going to mention any more about.
Thank you.
Yes. Right, so where can you find stability, security, and certainty? Can I ask you guys, do any of you own property in another country right now? Hands up.
What'd you say?
Do any of you own property in another country right now? Whereabouts, madam?
Roatan, Honduras.
Honduras, that's interesting. And did you buy that as an investment?
Yeah.
You did. And how long ago did you buy it?
2005.
Wow, so you've been there. And you use it yourself as well?
It's just land right now.
Just land, so you're going to construct from it, I guess, yeah? Or sell it. But it's appreciated, yeah?
Not yet.
Sir, whereabouts did you invest?
I have two properties in Medellin, Colombia, and one in Playa del Carmen.
Good choice, Medellin.
Yeah. And one in Playa del Carmen, Mexico.
Another one. I should make this man come up and talk. He knows where he's buying. Anybody else? Where did you buy, sir?
Escazú.
Where's that?
Costa Rica.
Costa Rica. And did you buy a long time ago, or did you buy recently?
No, just 10 years ago.
Okay. So Costa Rica, as far as we're concerned, as developers, it's already developed. it's very expensive to get in on the ground floor in a country like Costa Rica, which I'll explain a bit more about as the goes on. Sorry, sir.
In Belize, San Ignacio, and San Pedro.
Okay, again, recently?
No, about 5 years ago.
And what did you buy? Did you buy an apartment or land?
Land.
And what's your plan for that land?
To build on it.
Okay, and you're going to oversee that yourself? Or
yes.
You are. That's very important in development. That's paramount, actually. Mm-hmm. Okay. So as I mentioned before, we're developers. And we've identified the Dominican Republic for a number of reasons. Most of these reasons, in fact, probably all of them, you've already discussed to some degree with the guys that were up here before me. Okay? What does the Dominican have to offer? This has already been covered. Maria, I know, she's sat back paying attention, has explained all of this. One of the strongest economies, the biggest economy for definite in the Caribbean. Excellent yields on rental properties. Favourable landlord laws. Generous tax incentives. And a shortage of quality accommodation. Don't know if that's been covered. Overall, there's, I think, 800,000. There's a shortage in the country of 800,000 what they call executive accommodation units. Not just in Santo Domingo, that would be Santiago and everywhere else as well, Punta Cana, and 8 international airports and the infrastructure, which is very well established. And it's a peaceful democratic society. The second passport operator. Have you discussed the second passport in the rep you have?
Okay.
So it's more than just a tourist destination. There's a lot more happening in this country than people give it credit for. It's not just agriculture and it's not just tourism. Okay, you have the BPOs, you know, business processing, outsourcing, agriculture, there's lots of other businesses, lots of new companies invested in there for a number of different reasons. The English is very good. There's call centres. Lorica, for example, is a big one based in the middle of the city. I think they've got 4 offices, and it's all servicing utility companies, I think, and computer call centres and stuff like that. This is the neighbourhood where we build. Does this one have a laser on it?
Yes,
sorry. Okay, let me just explain to you. We develop in a business district in an area called Piantini in Serrayes. That area, which is essentially here, hang on. I'm not very good at driving these things. But this area here is what they call the Polygono de Oro. So around here you have all the shopping centres, you have all the malls. This is a screenshot from booking.com based on what it would cost you in October to stay for 1 month in this area. Okay, so $3,000 there. That one's no longer available. Seven, that's the Marriott suite. Obviously, that one's going to be crazy expensive. $4,500 there. $2,565 there. Our building is here. Literally, that park there. Done it again. Bear with me. See that park? That's Serrayes Park. So we're building one. I think that's because I'm nervous. We're building one there, which is almost finished, literally looks down onto this park here, and the other one is on this street here. So in this same area. And these two roads, you've got Abraham Lincoln there, over here you have Churchill. This is the core of the business district of this city. Now all the banks, head offices are all in this area here, all the shopping centres, everything you want from a capital city is essentially within a 10-minute walk of that area there. I mean, you can see where the Marriott is. Holiday Inn is 10 minutes away. It's very close. It's a small capital city, really. There's 4 million people who live there. And everything's quite condensed. It's easy to get around, you know, outside of rush hour. But from an investment perspective, for us, it makes perfect sense for us to build there. This is just an illustration about the GDP and how it's increased since 2006, year on year. Right, now this is an interesting one. Am I going too fast for you? Okay, right. This is an interesting one. I love looking at maps. Who likes looking at maps? Okay, I understand if you don't want to admit it. It's a personal thing. But this is us here. Now, this is the price per square metre of what we would call a luxury executive apartment. So that's an apartment with Spanish or Italian tiles, Italian kitchen, granite worktops, all imported fixtures and fittings. In the capital centre, in the business district of the capital centre, the capital city. And these are the other comparable prices in the region. So say, for example, Panama, very expensive. Costa Rica's not on there. Costa Rica, I know, also is very expensive now. Although Costa Rica's an interesting one because San Jose hasn't kind of developed into a kind of corporate entity to the same degree that other, like Panama has, for example. So if you look at all these surrounding islands, like for example, I get a lot of clients from Turks and Caicos, British Virgin Islands, where's the other one? Turks and Caicos, Curacao, come to the Dominican Republic just to do the shopping, because the flights are cheap, it's 40 minutes on a plane, and they haven't got access to all of the shops and all the facilities that we do here. That's a functioning city. A lot of these places have capitals. Turks and Caicos is the capital, the main city there is Providenciales, but there's no shops there, there's no facilities, there's just beautiful beaches, golf courses, condos. So they can jump on a plane and for $200 they can be in the Dominican Republic. Okay, Belize is kind of on a path. Cayman Islands, I mean look, Florida, 7,000, that's Miami, really. So $2,100 for a finished apartment in the business district is still reasonable. Ours come in at under $2,000, but that's the average. Barbados, I mean that's cheap in Barbados. But the ex-British colonial ones are always crazy expensive. The view that's $7,000 the same as the moment. Who should you invest with? Well, me, obviously. Right, would Rambling Dan, everybody knows Rambling Dan, be able to properly care for your investment? Who should you invest with? Rather than a one-man band, why not go with the orchestra, which is our company? This is a little analogy that our marketing department dreamt up. This is the Santo Domingo Philharmonic Orchestra. And this is who we are. Right, Real Capital Ventures is the, if you like, the umbrella company of the organisation. Around Investing is a strategic partner. This is partnerships that we work with in other agents based in Europe, Switzerland, Dubai. Real Capital Caribe is who I work for. We are the construction company and the development company and the marketing company based in the Dominican Republic. And American Wise Investments is their management company. And my colleague, the handsome Italian chap at the back there, Antonio, you can all turn around discreetly, ladies. There he is. He's going to come and talk to you about it. He's responsible solely. He's based in Florida. He's an ex-financial manager for Barclays Bank. He deals with the management and the operating of all of our buildings in Miami and Venice, Naples, Florida, in general. And he's going to explain how the management of your property is handled by us. Because that's the key, that's one of the main concerns when you buy a property to rent, is it going to be looked after? Who's going to be looking after it? What's the worst case scenario? What's the best case scenario? What happens if my kitchen breaks down, my cat leaks, mirror crack? All these things are all dealt with by a separate entity that is our management wing. What do we have to offer? Right, commitment to clients both before and after sales. We have a track record of sourcing clients. I mean, a great example, Central Park Tower, which is our first tower, was bought. We sold 80% of it in 5 weeks to clients that had already invested with us in Miami. Okay, so they bought when the property was low, and they sold when the property was high, and they had great yields and great returns on all those properties from 2008, I think, until we started construction, which was late 2017. And so subsequently, 80% of the apartments that we sold in 5 weeks, and we sold them to existing clients. Vision backed by research. Now, before we decided to build anything in Santo Domingo, we looked at all the surrounding areas, we looked at all the competing islands, all the developing markets. We also went to Colombia, we also went to Curacao, we went to Belize, we went to Panama, and for a number of different reasons, to be honest with you, it's more to do as a developer with the cost of the land, the cost of construction, and what that passes then on to the client in terms of a yield. We're very lucky in Santo Domingo because labour is quite cheap. Most guys use Haitian labour. They're very good guys. We've got maybe 120 guys working for us for both towers. But the cost of the land here, the land that we build on, most of the plots in this area, Serres, are old family villas. So you buy the villa and you build a tower. In order for us to make that work for us financially, we have to be able to buy the land at the right price and then construct it at the right price. And then be able to sell it onto a client that can then generate sustainable yields. Now, we can do that right now because of the cost of the land. There's only a finite number of plots available in that overall general area. When they're gone, you know, they're old families, but all Spanish villas basically. When they're all gone, these yields are going to be unachievable and the price of the property is going to rise. Experience and forward thinking opportunities. We've been doing this now for about 10 to 15 years. We've got two or three other projects in the pipeline. We're possibly looking at building a spa. Some of our shareholders are Italian. Possibly building a spa in Punta Cana, although that's not been finalised yet. We're probably going to build a third tower as well in Santa Domingo. And why buy from us? An investment might be good on paper, but only an experienced company in property management can take this investment and make it perform. Right, so we have years of experience, advanced software, which Antonio is going to explain to you in about a minute. Excellent service, there's the Philharmonic again. Right, property management, choose carefully, market effectively, and treat tenants with respect. Right, and is this where you come in, Antonio? This
not really, but if you like.
If you're missing, yeah, I think you should come in.
Yeah.
Because he's familiar with the software that we use, which is this property way thing, so I'll hand you over to him.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Antonio Naddeo. And I am one of the directors of Real Caribe and also the managing director of American Wise Investments, our sister company based in Fort Lauderdale. I'm really excited to be here to be part of this presentation, and I really hope you will agree with me that and start a very good job right now at explaining you the reasons behind this project and why we feel so comfortable and confident about the kind of returns that in a second we will explain we believe we will be able to achieve on these investments. With regard to the returns, and it is actually where I really become part of this equation, with American Wise Investments, I look after the property management of a very large real estate portfolio that we have in Florida, running all the way from Miami to Palm Beach. It's a very large one, and I've been involved with that portfolio for the last 5 years. And the experience accumulated over the last 5 years, the many lessons learned, mistakes made, and as my father always reminds me, in life you never lose, you either learn or win. So there is a lot really going on in Florida, as I'm sure you are aware, a very large variety of units, apartments, single family homes, condominiums, all that experience, all that knowledge is what I personally offer into this project, into this equation. How do we do that? Well, first of all, we have a team of about 5 people working for American Wise Investments right now that I lead, property managers with plenty of experience, and the combination of the human factor, if you like, together with PropertyWare. I don't know if any one of you is actually familiar with PropertyWare at all. I guess no. Okay. PropertyWare in the property management industry is one of the leading companies. Okay. They produce a very efficient software that allows for the management of anything between 1 to 1,000 units, okay? It's a very sophisticated, quite expensive, I must say, but it's definitely worth the money that we invest. It's basically a subscription-based software that pretty much does everything from being able to produce ledgers for the benefits of the landlord, the owner, to ledgers for the tenants, so that you can reconcile on a daily, weekly, monthly basis your accounting and make sure that basically everything works. Helps you to produce work orders, which are automatically submitted to a pool of contractors that you had previously, if you like, built and linked to PropertyWare. And through the property managers and through PropertyWare, we are able right now to be extremely efficient and effective in the way that we look after our clients, our existing clients, and we look after our units. Darren made a very good point before. It's about respecting and treating fairly our tenants and making sure that basically our landlords eventually achieve their goal, which is a XYZ return on their investments. In Santo Domingo, we are going to apply the exact same rules of efficiency. I like to refer to them such efficiency, really, to your units. Because, let's be frank, it doesn't really matter how beautiful and stylish our units may be. It doesn't matter how vibrant and exciting Santo Domingo can be and how gorgeous and lovely the weather in the Dominican Republic will be. If you fail to efficiently manage and maintain your units, your investments will be worth zero. And that is basically where we believe that property management becomes key to your returns. Santo Domingo, we will live in loco. And when I mean in loco, I mean within the premises of the building where hopefully you will buy units from. We will have what we call the A team of contractors, basically handymen, plumbers, electricians, which would be, I would say, a ride on the elevators away from your tenants. Okay, it would be just a matter of, you know, calling them, and they would be able within a matter of hours, till minutes to basically acknowledge the problem. Typically, within a matter of hours, being able to resolve the problem. Of course, this service is provided as part of the overall package, of which Gavin later on will give you some extra details. I think it's a given that when you have a very good engine, a very good performing engine, the key is maintaining that engine. And it is exactly what we take pride, and I personally take very much pride in, because as I said, I am right now directly involved with the Floridian, if you like, side of our real estate portfolio, and will be very soon directly involved with Santo Domingo based opportunity as well. I don't think there's, unless you have specific questions, which probably we can take at the end of the presentation,
You got the Brooklyn accent.
I was actually ready with a joke, and then you introduced me in such a flattering way, the Italian, you know, the handsome Italian at the bottom. You just took away the opportunity from me.
Don't stand up there, Andrew. It makes me look bad.
You mean all
the... I look fat in a jacket. Right, so... This is what Antonio gives to the clients. This is, you know, do you want to explain?
Absolutely. This is basically just, by the way, you know, we had to remove some of the details clearly for the privacy of our existing clients. But what you see, it's actually a true ledger that we produce on a monthly basis for our clients. Where you basically have, you know, the period reference. So this ledger was produced for the month of February, I believe, okay, of this year, 2017. And in a nutshell, basically shows you the income being paid by the tenants, the property management fee that we take. Of course, numbers will vary depending on the project, depending on the agreements that we have with the specific clients. But you will basically see money in, money out, and that right at the end of it, you will basically see that at the end of this ledger, we indicate how much will be paid to our clients due to owner. And this is gonna be transferred electronically from our escrow account to whatever account the landlord, the owner, indicated. So it doesn't really get any easier and any clearer and simpler than this. Money in, expenses covered by the rent that we collect, money out. Okay.
Everybody happy still? You still with me? Wake up in the back. Right, this is our first tower. This is called Central Park. This is the one I mentioned earlier on, which is nearly sold out. There's two units left in this. These units, one is a very big one is a penthouse. There's two units remaining. What can I say? The majority of them are one bedrooms. The two units that is remaining is a cancellation. Lady from Tennessee bought it. Her husband sadly got very ill. She cancelled the contract, and it's available in a penthouse again. It's just come back on the market again as a cancellation. This is a tower that's kind of 80-90% completed right now. It's in the residential road, tree-lined boulevard. You can walk to the supermarket, restaurants, everything. Park at the end of the street. These towers both have all amenities of a five-star hotel. So for this one, for example, on the first level here, you've got a cafeteria, a bar, you've got a sauna, you've got a gymnasium, you've got a games room, and a business center. Yeah, so all the facilities, both towers have all of these facilities. great as well because it's got a pool on the first floor, which is fantastic. Some towers may come with either a pool or a gym or a combination of the two. Although I've not seen many that have all of those facilities incorporated within the tower. This will have 24-hour security, it'll have electronic access. All the facilities, again, like I say, you would associate with a 4-star, 5-star hotel.
Parking
as well, yeah. One parking per apartment, which we have to do. I mean, these towers are expensive to build because of the underground car parking. I mean, 25% of the cost of construction is what goes into the ground. This is in a lovely neighbourhood. All your neighbours are going to be driving around in $200,000 cars, 40% import duty on cars. There's 2 units about. These 2 units will be gone within the next 10 days, I would imagine. And this, I've got some pictures on here of how far forward we are with the construction. This speaks for itself. This was largely bought by investors off plan, and most of those investors, it's predominantly American, Canadian, European to a lesser degree, and also some Venezuelans and a Filipina, who's, as far as I'm aware, the only Filipina in the country. This is an overview of Central Suites. Now, this is a different business model. This is an apart hotel. So,
can I ask a question?
You can.
If you go back one slide, what's the street address for that property?
13 KA Escoto Gomez.
And you've got 2 units of how many bedrooms?
One is 2 bedrooms, and one of the penthouse is just a 1-bed. It's the only 1-bed penthouse. All the other penthouses are 2-bed, and the second unit, which is a 2-bed for sale, is on the 6th floor. It's a nice unit. It's basically 2 apartments that have been incorporated into one with like a big kitchen. It's got an American style kitchen with a washer area. Because you guys love washer dryers, right?
Yeah.
Patrick, do you get that? Patrick's my friend. Washer dryers, Americans, Canadians, they love them. So I'm not stereotyping anybody. Right, so, and that's a residential product. So, I mean, essentially, people that are bought there are going to rent for long, medium to long term. So they'll be renting out to middle class Dominicans, professionals, engineers, doctors, pharmacists, so on and so forth, expats to a lesser degree. There's a lot of expats that live in that area. And they'll rent those between 6 months and 12 months. And they should easily generate, I mean, those units, the cheaper units, they started from maybe $6,000 when we launched that project off that. The 2 units remaining now, the big 2-bedroom, for example, is $169,000, and the penthouse is $155,000. These units here, different concept. This is an apart hotel. This has been, we've sold 70% of these already. There's 20 apartments left. Okay, they're all about 50 square meters, 1-bed apartments. This will be run as a hotel. People will be paying. The nearest hotel to this is the Holiday Inn, which is the one I showed you earlier on, which I think costs you $3,500 a month, generates $3,500, $4,000. I can't remember. Do you remember, Sabrina?
I'm sorry?
Do you remember what the price of the Holiday Inn? The Holiday Inn was not available.
The Holiday Inn was unavailable, yes.
Right, okay. So they'll be paying between $85 and $120 a night to stay here. Again, this has all the same facilities, although this one has on the roof is where the bar and the swimming pool is. That bit that overhangs there is actually the swimming pool. I've got a picture of it, which I'll show you in a moment. 72 apartment building designed for buy-to-let investment. Nobody's going to live in these apartments. They're just bought as wealth creation tools, you know, a passive investment tool. They range in price. There's 2 left for under $100,000. 97, I think, and $99,000. The most expensive unit in here is about $135,000, $136,000. Okay, and these will easily generate 10 to 11.5% yields annually after all cost of net. Sorry, Patrick.
Can I ask you a question? When Antonio was talking about the building just before, we were talking about the management program that we have and the software and all that. How is that paid into? Is it paid into through the HOA fees, or is it a fixed rate that you have to pay? How where does that come in, or is it
that cost is possible?
No,
that's something that we do is the management. The management in that tower, for example, is 10% of any yield you might
approve.
That property management, so that's shouldered by the management company.
Correct.
That's very good. Do you have any more questions on that?
Not for now.
You sure? Piece of plant. So this is a buy-to-let investment. These have been sold. We've sold the majority of these to investors. Some people that want to qualify for their $200,000, you know, residency visa. Others have just bought it as a wealth creation tool. You know, if you spend, for example, you buy an apartment here for $97,000, $99,000, by the time you've paid all your exes, bought furniture, furniture isn't included. It's $113,000 investment. It's going to generate 10.5%. And that's all year round, okay? Remember, it's a city with 4 million people. That's all year round. So this isn't subject to bad weather. This isn't subject to flight delays. It isn't subject to any of those things that you would normally associate with kind of resort developments. This is a functioning hotel in a city with 4 million people. There we go, 8%, 12%. Depending on the kind of unit you buy. Full ownership, so it's a titled ownership. And it's going to be managed as a luxury apartment. Now. And this is the area, this is the Polygono di Oro in here. This is where I was kind of explaining to you earlier on where all the hotels are. Here's a list here on the left, the Agora Mall. The Blue Mall is the big luxury mall. That's from Churchill over here. Number five, no, that's the Acropolis. Yeah, Blue Mall's number two. Are you guys familiar with the city? Anybody been here? Anybody familiar with Santo Domingo? You are. Okay, that's good. Makes my job much easier. Shame it's only two of you though. Why haven't more of you been?
Just learning.
Okay. Hopefully you come after you've seen this presentation. Even if it's just another copy of Antonio.
I'm serving you here just like this, all your things.
This is the start of construction on Central Park Tower. This was December 2016. And that's what it looked like as of kind of 2 weeks ago. So these are the bathrooms here, and this is the construction. That apartment that I mentioned earlier on that was available is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It's this one here, which goes down to the side as well. This is a rendering of the business suite. Again, this will be for the exclusive use of all the residents. And this is a standard apartment in Central Park. Again, this is the lobby and central suites. Central suites, again, you have a car park on two levels. Each apartment will have its own space. And another rendering. There's the roof of central suites. So you have a bar up here, a lounge and deck area, and you have an infinity pool, which is what you can see in the other area, which hangs slightly over the building.
Yes.
So, which would be great if you buy this apartment here. That one's going to be sold. And this is a picture of the colonial zone. Let's just take a moment to ponder, reflect, and absorb the beauty of this picture, which is Christopher Columbus pointing in the correct way. In Barcelona, they've got exactly the same statue, pointing in the wrong direction. That's true. The colonial zone is the main touristic element of the city. It's absolutely breathtaking. And if you're anyone interested in history, it's the oldest city built by Europeans in the Americas. It's absolutely fascinating. If you're interested in history, you can walk around there for hours. I mean, I've spent hours walking around there with my daughter, I've got an 8-year-old daughter, and you don't even scratch the surface. It's absolutely fascinating. If you watch that movie, 1492, Conquest of Paradise, where Gerard Depardieu is trying to, you know, have you seen that movie anymore? Now, when they're pulling the bell up with the horse, that's the church there that they're doing it. You can see Columbus's house. It's like a little terraced house. It's incredible. He didn't buy an apartment, he bought like a little stone terraced house. And it's beautiful. At night time, it's illuminated beautifully. It's fantastic. If you want to go out and just absorb the atmosphere, it really is. You're 40 minutes away to world-class beach. I mean, I'm a builder selling a product, but if, from a lifestyle perspective, you're 40 minutes away. One Dolio, Boca Chica, obviously a bit further to go to Punta Cana. Patrick's place over at Samana is probably 2 hours. Yeah, Patrick, from us? Yeah. And this is a view of the city. Now, we are building in this cluster over here. So that's a great picture of the city. There's a picture of golf course. Hands up, who likes golf? One person admits it. Two. You Americans, two of you play golf. Nah, I don't believe you. I reckon. Do you play golf, sir? No, none of the ladies play golf. Anyway, that's a picture of a golf course. That's a picture of an Irish guy in golf course with the legs. And these are some of the schools. I heard briefly earlier on, the school system's been explained to you. The neighbourhood that we're in is very close to a number of the top end schools. St George's is probably the best in Piantini. My daughter doesn't go to that one because I can't afford it. Unless you guys buy all the rest of the apartments. And this is an example of a yield table. Now, this is based on either 70, 80 or 90% occupancy, and that $113,000 investment would be based on an apartment of about $100,000 by the time you bought furniture and paid the registration and the notary fees. So there you go, 8.6 at 70%, 10% at 80%. And we're looking at doing more between 80 and 90%. And if it's 90% occupancy, you're looking at 11.5%. Now, in central suites, the yield is pooled, right? So that means that if you are an apartment owner and your apartment isn't rented for, say, 3 weeks in June, but all the others are, that money is pooled and then split out amongst all the owners according to the value that they pay for their apartment. Okay, so if you buy one of the cheaper units at $99,000 and somebody else bought one at $135,000, the share of the yield will be split up. Yeah, like that. So that's kind of a straightforward one. Obviously, if you bought a more expensive unit, then that return will be higher. Passive investment. Everybody wants to lie on the beach and earn money. Who doesn't like the sound of lying on the beach earning money? I mean, I'd love to do it. I mean, I'm nearly 50. I should be thinking about that and stuff like this. Yeah, I know what you're thinking, because you're nearly 50. Mediterranean diet. My wife lives in the Philippines. Reserve your unit today. And that's a breakdown of, that's just an overall, an overview of what I've just explained. Does anybody have any questions?
Management fees, can you back up
where
you have those? What percentage?
There's two towers. One is a residential tower. The management fees in that one are 10% of whatever yield that the management company generates. In this one, which is run as an apart hotel, the management is 30%. Most of those costs will be shouldered by the management company though, when they rent the units out. And our calculations have been done with all of those figures taken into account.
So what you showed us, profits was
after. It was actually, yes, let me go back to that slide. It's actually in the beginning, it's one of the points in the book. Property management costs are on the line.
Yeah, right.
So the unit at the bottom is actually the rate of accounts for property management costs.
Yeah, so what's included in here would be an apartment of about $99,000. Furniture pack, which is anything between sort of $8,000 and $10,000, and your lawyer fees and stuff like that. So, because the second tower will have staff and people working in the kitchen and stuff like that, whereas the first tower has basically 24-hour security and concierge, has ministerial staff. Yes, sir.
The second tower, the Park Hotel, mm-hmm. You said that 70%.
Sold. Yeah.
Where did they start at when you started marketing them?
The price. Mm-hmm. Actually, those haven't actually changed because we haven't started construction. We're due to start construction on this one next month. They were 90,000. I think maybe 89,900. So they haven't got up that much. It's $10,000. Yeah. But these are a great investment if you don't want the headache and the grief. And you just don't want to deal with anything. I'm going to buy that for whatever reason, and I'm going to go and live somewhere else on the beach. Mm-hmm. This will generate the money. He will send you a check every 2, 3, or 6 months, however you want it done. You make those arrangements with him. We're a very flexible company.
Absolutely.
He Antonio can accommodate whatever requirements you have, and he can wire that money to whichever account you want as well. Dollar accounts in the Unicorn Republic.
Do you anticipate price appreciation? I see you have up there 5% capital appreciation year on year, but I'm talking about from the start of construction.
15%.
What do you think?
Based on the final price rise of the apartments that we're selling in the first tower, it's 15% more. This one, I don't know if this one would be the same. I would say conservatively at least 10%. You'll trouble you, aren't you? I know
what's
that
your,
came in.
What's your build out time from when you start construction?
This will be finished in December next year.
So 1 year? And
just over a year, yeah. Mm-hmm. August, you know, August, September, October. Yeah, yeah, 18 months. It's supposed to be December 2018. We're a month because we had some bad rain. So we're a month later with it. Well, we've done the excavation, and then it poured with rain for about 4 days. So you can appreciate that, you know. Now, these Haitian guys, they can't swim.
How do you handle the financing of that?
That's an excellent question, which should have been covered in this presentation, but it's probably my fault. We will do our own developer's finance for 50%. If you're looking for leverage on the product, then yeah, we could do 50% over 3 years, and we'll do that at interest only 8% payments.
But you have a down payment,
you'd have to come up with 50% if you do it that way, and then we would finance what we call the back end 50%.
So you wait till it's done and then you finance it?
Yeah. So you'd still make some profit, you just wouldn't make as much profit.
Right.
And the other thing, obviously, there's Dominican banks as well, which we work, for example, with Scotia Bank. They will lend to Americans, Canadians, and English people, apparently. I don't know quite why it works like that, sorry, to Italians.
No offense to you.
Yeah, I mean, they'll do 70% loan to value to non-residents as well. If you're a resident, then they'll do 90% and they'll do longer terms. But I'm not going to lie to you and tell you it's straightforward though. It's very bureaucratic when it comes to the right thing. Patrick will agree with me. You know, the banks over here don't as yet function to the same level as the banks obviously in America do and certain countries in Europe. So it's very, very bureaucratic. They want to see copies of everything and they want to see references and they want to see stuff like that. But providing you have all that kind of stuff at hand, then in theory it's very straightforward. It takes, what, 2 months, Patrick?
2 months, yeah.
But what you could do, we'd still want 50% as the developer. What you could do is you pay the 50%, you'd apply for your mortgage, and then they'd have released 70 or 90%, and you could call that cash back, and then you could buy another one of our apartments. Any other questions? I've got some brochures here, which feel free to put. Do you want me to leave them at the back, Bernie? Help yourself. I'm going to be outside another hour. If you want to come out and have a chat and have a coffee, talk to me about my experiences and whatever. You're more than welcome. But thanks for being so attentive at this late in the day. Sorry, do I have another question? Sorry, sir.
Central Park is sold out.
Two left. One is a one bed penthouse, and the other one is actually the the sixth floor one. I bet you sat at the front of the school, didn't you? The other one is the biggest apartment in the building. Is the sixth floor one, because it's two apartments combined. We had two bedroom duplexes in the penthouse, but even those were smaller than this one. This one's 1,300 square feet.
Sixth floor.
Sixth floor, base in the front.
And the cost?
That's $169,000. That one there, but it's that one and the whole side.
Oh, okay.
So you have two balconies here, and you have another balcony at one of the bedrooms here. It's a nice big bright apartment. It'd be great for a family but you can also live in an apartment that size. I mean, to be honest with you, these are investment apartments. I mean, you wouldn't want to live in a kind of 60 square meter apartment, generally speaking, but that's 106 square meters. I mean, you can live there.
What's your address?
13 K.A. Escoto Gomez. Do you want me to say that in a Spanish accent? 13 K.A. Escoto Gomez. If you need, I can send you a Google pin if you give me a mobile.
Okay.
Go on our website, there's up-to-date pictures of the construction and also more pictures for you to turn them down. They're currently on the final fit-out now, so they're tiling the floors, tiling the bathrooms, But all the walls have been plastered now, so it's going to be, ceilings will be a rendering, coatings going in, windows go in next week, the windows went in the other last week, so the windows are going in, and it's all been painted white, the exterior now, so it looks different from the windows now. But listen guys, thank you for letting me talk to you.
Thank you so much.
It's been an absolute pleasure.